Welcome to our course on the fundamentals of nanoelectronics. Now, I'm sure you're all familiar with the amazing progress in this field in the last few decades. You know, today's smartphones, these are just amazing things. And what allows it to do all these amazing things is that one of these actually contains like over a billion transistors. And the reason you can pack a billion transistors into a small thing like that is that each one is extremely small. So if you look at today's transistors and you looked at the active region, it's like a few hundred atoms across. See? Now, in the process of making it small, one thing that has also changed is the nature of current flow through these devices. So the picture we usually carry in our head of how electrons go through a device is this like a random walk. That is, it starts out at one end, hits something, turns around, hits something else, turns around again, and so on. But today's devices are down to a point where a better paradigm is ballistic transport. That's like a bullet. Now, historically, of course, our understanding started at the diffusive end. And so that's how the subject is taught. You start from this end and then try to project that understanding down to small devices. And what we believe is that that makes the subject unnecessarily complicated. And so what we have developed over the years is a reverse approach. You see, where we start from small devices and then use that understanding to understand bigger devices. See? And that allows us to talk about relatively difficult concepts. It's very advanced concepts of non-equilibrium statistical mechanics, but assuming only a minimal amount by way of prerequisites. The kind of prerequisite that every student in science and engineering has. Now, if you have taken courses in solid state devices or statistical mechanics or quantum mechanics, that's fine. Hopefully, you'll still enjoy this new perspective and the clarity it brings. But if you haven't had all that background, you should still be able to follow along. Now, we first offered this course 3 years back, and based on your feedback, we have reorganized certain parts, and we now plan to offer it again in spring of 2015. And the text has also been reorganized to go along with this new course, and registered students will have access to this manuscript. Thank you, and hope to see you in spring of 2015.